Hey everyone, and welcome to Boston Autoblog. In the automotive world, one word that we've become very accustomed to hearing is shortages. Whether it's chip shortages or car shortages, it's affecting everything from new to used cars. From the new side of things, you don't have a lot of variety to choose from at the moment. And then for used cars, the prices are absolutely skyrocketing, hitting their all-time highs. But even when times were good, even when dealers had plenty of cars to choose from, there wasn't a lot of vehicles that you could go with that would give you everything. Whether it was performance, luxury, comfort features, or practicality, you were sacrificing one aspect or another. Now, for some sports cars, you would have some great performance, great driving dynamics and handling, but maybe the interior quality wasn't up to par. Then also you have cars that are very luxurious, but are not going to give you that performance to match it. But today I'm taking a look at the 2018 Audi S4, a car that's very well-rounded, but also a sedan that's always been attainable for most car enthusiasts and even consumers looking for a car that will give them some performance, but also still have that class and executive nature to them. And that's why I am here to take a look at this car, because believe it or not, in 2021, even with used car prices very high, you can buy one of these for an affordable price, not break the bank, and get an amazing car. So in this video, we're going to experience the Audi S4 to its fullest. We're going to see if this car really is one of the best sedans on the market, especially in the used market, when you're looking at spending below $50,000. And also see why, if you're looking at making that upgrade, say you own a Volkswagen GTI, Audi S3, Volkswagen Golf R, then maybe going with the Audi S4 might be a great decision. Now, before we get into this video, I want to give a huge shout and thank you to Bernardi Audi of Natick in Natick, Massachusetts, for allowing me to do this review. Their link will be in the description below, so you can check out their extensive Audi inventory. Also, before we get started, make sure to click the subscribe button and also hit the notification bell so you're notified every time a new video goes live on the channel. And so, without wasting any further time, let's get right in this review. So we are in the 2018 Audi S4, and this is a car that is kind of in a good price range. You're spending somewhere between $40,000 and $50,000, and the S4 was always the go-to in the Audi lineup before the S3 showed up. And even today, I think the S4 is still the better option, whether you're looking at buying new or used. And this car, I think, is very formidable in the luxury sports sedan market when it goes up against the BMW M340i, also the Mercedes-Benz C43, and of course, some new additions like the Genesis G70. Now, with this model being a 2018, it is a B9 Gen for the S4, and it's somewhat of the middle child for the recent S4 history. So the B8 and B8.5 is really held in high regard for a few reasons. One, you have the option to go with the manual transmission, but also people really love the 7-speed dual clutch and also the supercharged V6. And I gotta be honest, still one of my favorite generations. But then the B9 came out and they made some huge differences and maybe even some improvements in some regards, depending on who you ask. But now you have a turbocharged V6. And even though you lose the supercharged whine, the sound of this engine and the exhaust is fantastic. It really gives you that sports car feel. But also what they did with this V6 is that they paired it with an 8-speed Tiptronic automatic transmission sourced by ZF. And I love ZF automatic transmissions. They're just really great and refined. However, there is one thing to point out here. Even though a lot of people do like the dual clutches and some people don't like the clunkiness of them, with this particular transmission, you do feel that it grabs the gears, especially when you're downshifting. So it's not as smooth as what you're going to see in, say, a BMW M340i, but as a car enthusiast, it adds a bit more to the engagement when you're behind the wheel and also accelerating. So even when you are accelerating like this, you do get that pushback. You do get that lock into the gear. And I love that as an enthusiast. It just really adds to the driving dynamics and really makes me more engaged as I'm driving on these nice winding back roads. Then when you look at the B9.5 facelift, that made this car far more dynamic in terms of design. A car that now looks the part. It looks like a sports car. And I think that's really where the B9 is going to get forgotten to a certain degree. I think now today, though, when you look at the price for even a used S4, it's not that bad. When you're looking at spending around $40,000 for this car, that's a lot better than some of the other options out there, which are still around $50,000, especially for the M340i and also the C43. And then if you are looking at buying an older F-Series BMW for the 340, I wouldn't recommend that. I just don't think the car feels that great when it comes to the driving dynamics. And it's still expensive, where this is, I think, priced pretty reasonably in the time that we're living in. Now, the cornering ability is impressive. You can really hug the corners, and you feel that sense of being planted. Even though this car doesn't sit that low of the ground, the steering just adds so much to this car. But that's one thing I really like about Audi and what they've done to their steering columns. You can really throw this car around and have a lot of fun, even though it's not the smallest car out there. It drives a lot smaller than it really is. I mean, this truly is a driver's car. It's for someone who wants to feel fully involved behind the wheel, whether you put it in manual mode or go through just automatic. This car is very vibrant. It's alive. Even though from the outside, it looks very unassuming. It looks like a regular A4, and that's really where the changes came for the B9.5, and I think it was a great decision to go in that direction where you had the honeycomb grille. But if you're somebody that's kind of looking to have fun but not really grab a lot of attention, then the B9 is certainly the way to go. But also, when you look at the understated design and exterior, it fits in with the understated performance. Because even though we have 354 horsepower and 369 pound-feet of torque under the hood, you really wouldn't know. And even the exhaust note, I'm beginning to wonder how much you can hear outside, because every single B9 I have seen on the road, S4 that is, you don't really hear the exhaust. I think some of it is being pumped in, but it sounds great. It really adds to the ambiance of the interior. But compared to some of its closest rivals, it doesn't have the striking road presence that's going to draw a lot of attention from onlookers and other drivers and motorists. So you can have a lot of fun on back roads, on the highway, and not get yourself into a lot of trouble. And that's why the S4, to me, is the perfect car for someone who's climbing up the ladder in life. That you owned a Volkswagen prior, but now you're getting into the Audis. Maybe you owned a Volkswagen GTI or Jetta GLI, and you're looking for something that's a little bit more luxurious, a little more upscale, but has better performance. And that's where the S4 is always slot into place. And that's why I think a lot of buyers who are enthusiasts that owned Volkswagens in the past, they won't go to BMW. They won't go with the M340i. They won't really go to the Mercedes-Benz C43 either. And what really works in this car's favor is that you don't have an RS4 model. So you'd have to go RS3, which I still think is a bit too compact, at least for my liking. I want something a little bit bigger, a little bit more luxurious. Whereas if you're looking for an S4, you're going to have those leather materials. You're going to have some soft touch padding found throughout, but also I like the carbon fiber inlay as well. So the interior feels very homey and also luxurious, but when you step behind the wheel and you start accelerating, that's when this car has its bad side to it. And that's why I think it's a perfect match for a lot of buyers. But let's get into the interior aspect for the B9 for a minute, because this car, in my opinion, has aged very gracefully when it comes to the dashboard and button layout. But also, if you're a person who is really focused on the driving dynamics and keeping your hands on the wheel at all times and being focused on the road ahead, there's one key aspect that you're gonna like about the B9 over the B9.5. Now, the reason why I like the B9 generation over the B9.5 is because the rotary dial, touchpad, and quick access buttons to go along with your radio presets all being on the center console. Audi does a great job with their center console layouts and design. It makes the car seem a lot bigger than in reality. It's nice and wide. And that's one thing I do like about Audi interiors. They do feel a bit upscale and classier than what the price tag suggests. Now, the reason why Audi removed the touchpad and the rotary dial is because they have now a 10.2-inch touchscreen, which is very easy to use, very responsive. The quality is amazing and on par with its rivals. However, as a driver, I love having the rotary dial set up because now I can focus on the road ahead of me and just use the dial, and now I can scroll to different menus. Whereas with the newer Audis, I now have to touch the screen, and you know, maybe it takes my attention off the road, which is really just a safety thing. I would like to see the rotary dial make its return, but I believe, remembering the B9.5 S4 that I reviewed last year, the center console became far more cleanly designed. Also, what you're going to like too with the dashboard layout is that you will have your dual zone climate control, 3-level heated seats, and then beneath that is your drive mode selector, your auto start stop button, and your traction control on and off switch, all within arm's reach. The interior is very nice and driver centric, and it's one thing that I certainly love about Audi's designs. Then when it comes to the Audi's virtual cockpit, still in my mind, one of the best out there, if not the best. And I've been getting a lot of messages asking me, Mike, why do you like Audi's virtual cockpit so much? Why do you say it's better than Mercedes-Benz and BMW? And it's because BMW's digital gauge cluster is really just stagnant. There's nothing you can do with it. You can't change it up, really. Whereas Audi, you can scroll through different menus, you can customize it, personalize it, just like Mercedes-Benz. Although I think that Mercedes-Benz is just a little too in-depth for me. Where I think with Audi, it's nice the way it is. It's in-depth, but it's also intuitive as well. And Audi's done an amazing job with their technology. I think they're a tech company more than luxury, especially now in 2021. And it shows even for a vehicle that's almost 4 years old now. But also with the eye candy, you have carbon fiber inlay everywhere on this car, whether it's the center console, the dashboard, or the door panels. It's just great to see. As a car enthusiast, it draws me in. It gets me excited to really experience this car and drive it around and just have a lot of fun. And that's why Audi, to me, understands what it means to be a car enthusiast, especially in this segment and price range. Now, you can opt for a different inlay, but to me, that makes this car more of a, just a more sportier version of an A4. And for a lot of people who are maybe walking by or driving on the road, they see this car and they're like, oh, it's just a luxury sedan. But to the people who know this car best, when you see the quad exhaust tips, you know this car means business. And then when you step inside, that carbon fiber inlay really sets the mood. It gets you excited, and that's why I really like it. Then, of course, the Nappa leather seats provide a good amount of bolstering. They're very aggressive, and not only for the backs, but also for the hips as well. So you're going to be kept in place on a very aggressive drive on some winding back roads. But also, if you're just commuting to work Monday through Friday, it's a very comfortable place to be. And that's what I like about this car, is that it works in two different ways. It's a luxury sedan, but it's also a sports car as well. So when you want to have fun, you want to get frisky, put it in dynamic mode, have a blast. But then if you're driving, you know, conservatively, you want to just enjoy the suburban roads or maybe some highway cruising, put it in comfort mode and the car will just relax and you can relax as well. So this car, to me, is very driver-centric, driver-focused, but also doesn't forget that it's also a luxury sedan as well. But also you have, in my opinion, a car that's practical enough where you can drive this car on a daily basis if you do have kids. Then for the passengers in the back, if you do have some friends tagging along with you on a longer drive, they should be pretty comfortable because this seat is adjusted further back. It's also somewhat on a recline. And me at 5'5", I still have a few inches of legroom to work with here. So I can just sit back, relax, and recline in these seats. They provide some bolstering as well. Not very aggressive, but they will definitely keep you in place for sure on a longer drive. And if your friend wants to drive aggressively, you at least can hold tight and feel very secure. Now, the reason why I say the Audi S4 could borderline be a Grand Tour is because the center hump is very aggressive. I do not think you're going to be fitting three people in the back across, there's just no way, especially if you do have average size adults, because the foot placements, there's not a good amount of room there, and it will impede a bit when it comes to leg room, but also even shoulder room as well. And cars of this size are never known to offer enough room where you can fit five people overall in a sedan, especially in this segment. So this would be to be expected, especially amongst its competitors. And then sitting behind the driver's seat at my height around 5'5", I have an abundant amount of legroom to work with here. And this is why you want to go with the S4 over the S3. Because if you do have kids in the back, they're going to be nice and comfortable. They're not going to be claustrophobic at all, especially if you do not try squeezing a third person in the center. So I think that when it comes to its practicality, especially for people, for legroom, shoulder room, this is why you want to upgrade to the S4 over the S3. But also for a car of this size, it's still pretty spacious for sure. Also back here, you will have two rear air vents, and our model has climate control back here to go along with 3-level heated seats, also a 12-volt outlet. And of course, rounding out the rear seating area, you do get a center armrest with two cup holders. Now coming around to the back for the rear cargo area, you're going to receive right on 13 cubic feet of rear cargo room, which is more than enough and totally adequate if you do live by yourself or you have a significant other, because I was able to fit all my camera gear back here with two tripods, two camera bags, and also a gimbal box, and I still had plenty of room for groceries and smaller items. Now, even though 13 cubic feet doesn't sound like a whole heck of a lot, it is on par with its closest rivals and a bit better than the Genesis G70. Then on either side of the rear cargo area, you will have some netting for some smaller items. So if you have car detail equipment or water bottles, you can leave them there and they won't get thrown on your more valuable items. So if you are on the fence about whether to go with an S3 or an S4, I think the S4 is certainly the better option because you will have enough room for times you want to go away for the weekend, or if you are going to the mountains to ski and snowboard, you are going to have enough room for some gear, and that's one thing that the S3 is not going to provide. But also, if you are wondering, oh, is it going to provide enough practicality for me? Is it spacious enough? Well, I think you could definitely have two smaller kids in the second row and also have enough room where you can grocery shop and maybe even move some smaller items. So in my mind, the S4 is practical enough, but also has the daily driving aspects that makes it a perfect sports sedan. Now, getting into the driving dynamics for the S4, and more importantly, the atmosphere that you find yourself in, first, let's start off with the vision that you have here to work with when it comes to your front vision, also side mirrors as well. And you do have a nice panoramic view in front of you where you can see everything. The A-pillars are not very aggressive at all. The only thing that I am noticing, though, is that I do have a bit of a more narrow view for the rear, window. But when it comes to the side mirrors, you do have blind spot detection, and also they are placed pretty nicely as well, so I can see what's in my blind spots. Also, when it comes to this leather wrap steering wheel, it feels really nice in the hands. You have very aggressive 10-2 positions, and it just adds to a sense of quality. This car is dialed in really nicely, but also the fit and finish, to me, is one of the best in this segment. You get a nice pull in this car. You certainly feel the torque. And when you compare that to, say, a BMW M340i, or even some of the non-German brands, you're not going to get it as much. And that's one of the reasons why I think I do like this Tiptronic 8-speed over the ZF 8-speed that we see in the BMW M340, because that's too smooth for me. This, I actually get a kickback when I accelerate. I actually feel the car engaging into that gear, and it just adds so much to the driving experience. And now, with so many cars now having that ZF 8-speed, the transmissions are so crisp and so smooth that it does kind of take away from the driving experience, especially if you're somebody who maybe had a manual transmission in the past, maybe an older S4, and now you're hopping into a new S4. You want to have that feedback. You want to get that throwback through the gears. And this transmission allows you to have that. And that's really nice. But one aspect that I really love about the S4 is the steering input. Now, it is not as heavy, it is not as weighted when it comes to the steering as you're going to notice with, say, a BMW M340i or Mercedes-Benz C43. But when you're on winding back roads, when you're in the corners, you can have so much fun with this car, and it drives a lot smaller than it really is. It feels like an S3 inside, even though it's certainly not the same size, but you can really throw it around. You can have a lot of fun, and there's a lot of confidence there. Whereas with some of the other German cars, you have a very weighted steering, very heavy, and yeah, it does give you that feedback, but I think to a certain degree, it's too aggressive. Where this, you can really have a lot of fun. This car, even though it wouldn't be considered a grand tour, I still think that on winding back roads up in the mountains somewhere, you can have so much enjoyment behind the wheel with this car. You get that kickback in your seat. It is so nice, but it's effortless. This car can go from 0 to 60 in around 4.3 seconds, and I wouldn't be surprised that in the right conditions, it could probably do it in 4 seconds flat. This car just feels fantastic. It feels so refined. You don't hear any rattling, you don't hear anything, and it certainly still feels like a luxury car. It may not have the soft touch padding on the dashboard like we see with the rest of the interior, but this is still a luxury car. It still feels really nice. You can totally drive this on a daily basis. Now, I said earlier on that the S4 is a car that you really can't get yourself into trouble in because it flies below the radar. It has a very unassuming appearance. I don't know. After about 30 minutes, I don't think so. In fact, I think you can get yourself into a lot of trouble if you're not careful. When you take in consideration that you have a car that has so much torque that can get you up to speed pretty quickly, but also a car that gives you that confidence in the corners where you can have a lot of fun, where you have the ability to take sharper corners at higher speeds, this to me is really the perfect daily driver. Just throw it in the corners and it has no problem doing so. This is fantastic. This is really, really enjoyable. So as I wrap up this test drive for the S4, what are my final thoughts on this? And I gotta be honest, it's pretty impressive. It really is. For a car priced on the used market around $40,000, this might be one of the best you can find right now for sure. Now, I understand that some people are gonna say, well, you could probably buy an S3 for a little less. You could also go with a Volkswagen Golf R, which if you can find one at this price range, that would be great. But I don't know. I'm not sure I would look at buying a brand new sports car at this price range over buying a used S4. Because I think when you're looking at the price point where these really haven't appreciated that much, and in fact, I do think that the B9.5 is going to be more coveted just because of its looks. This car is a gem right now, especially in 2021 and with a chip shortage. This car is really fun. It's really enjoyable. This is one of the best I've driven so far over the last few years, and I have no idea why I waited so long to review one of these. So in closing, I thoroughly enjoyed my time with the Audi S4. In fact, it's a bit sad to part ways, as I really, truly enjoyed driving this car on the winding back roads west of Boston. It handled every single situation with ease, and that's exactly what I want to see from a luxury sports sedan. But also more importantly is that this car is so understated from the exterior. You wouldn't know that it has over 350 horsepower and 369 pound-feet of torque under the hood. You wouldn't know that it can go from 0 to 60 in around 4 seconds. It's a car that can fly below the radar. It doesn't shout and scream and say, I'm a troublemaker. I'm one that's going to be driving really fast. You can actually drive this in the suburbs, on the highway, and you can drive it the way you want. If you want to drive aggressively, you can. No one's even going to notice. You can also just drive comfortably on a weekly basis when you're going to work, and you can really enjoy that interior comfort aspect. This car, to me, and I see why so many people love the S4, because it provides everything. It provides that comfort, it provides that performance, but also, as we demonstrated throughout this video, it's still somewhat practical, more so than the Audi S3, but also you have enough cargo space where you can load up all your gear. If you're like myself and you have camera gear, you can do that. You can go on a weekend road trip. That's what this car is designed to do. It's really, to me, even though it's a sports sedan, it is a grand tour. It's comfortable. It's meant to be driven on longer drives. And that's why, to me, even though it might not get the same level of attention like the BMW M340i or even the Mercedes-Benz C43, it's a car that can still give you a lot of fun, practicality, but also comfort and luxury as well. And that's why I feel, even though this car is a sports sedan, it's also executive as well. And that's why it does fit the character of the buyer who drives these cars, and really one in which I think is one of the best cars you can buy right now in 2021 on the used car market. But if you are looking at buying a new sports sedan, I would definitely recommend taking a look at the B9.5, take it out for a test drive, and experience it for yourself. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe for more. Also, make sure to follow me on Instagram at Boston Auto Blog so you can see what I'm up to and what vehicles I'll be featuring in the future. And I will see you guys next time.